The first reading today taken from the book of Job and the gospel sort of jibe. They are like bookends. One tells us, ask us a question, who shut within doors the sea? And the gospel answers the question about who. And that was Christ the Lord, God, the Son of God incarnate. Today we have questions. Sinong may sala? Sinong salarin? Sinong may gawa ng lahat ng ito? Bakit ang daming in-check ng mga pogo sa Pilipinas? Bakit sila may student visa? Bakit sila may mga baril at may mga uniforme? At bakit pati isla ay nabebenta ng mga politiko? The question during Job's time is the same as our question. Who, why, what, wherefore, para ke, para saan, ano ang kahihinatnan ng lahat na ito, ano ang pinagmulan, ano ang dahilan? And Job had every right to question God. Job had a comfortable life. He was relatively wealthy. He had a lot of animals, domesticated. He had a very good family. He was wealthy beyond measure, at least by the standards of the time. It is easy to love God when you're okay, when your job is good, when you receive a salary that never misses every 15th and 30th of the month. It is easy to love God when your neighbors don't blame you and don't invent false narratives about you. It is easy to pray when everything goes on well. But then came the storms of life. And then we ask God, bakit? Bakit ako? When your life is going well, it is easy to go to church every Sunday. You got your car, you got your katulong, you have your job, you have your task set out for you. All you need to do is to spend 1 hour every week to praise God more or less because life is so good to me. And then it is so easy to say, praise the Lord, when everything is going well. But then you realize that we are facing storms of various kinds. And then the Lord tells us, let us cross over to the other side. And crossing over to the other side means you've got to leave your comfort zone. You've got to test out something that you have not tried. You've got to put your faith to the test and see whether you really believe in God or only in the God idea. And it is very easy to believe in the God idea. But then when God gives you trials and allows you to have troubles, and your neighbors are making your life miserable, nagtatapon ng basura, nakaparada yung kotse sa harap ng gate mo, at ay pag pinagsabihan mo, ikaw pa ang masama. And every driver that you meet on the road is at fault, except you, of course. And you blame and curse everybody in Doña Soledad or in the skyway, as the case may be. It is easy, when everything goes well, to think that God is good. But then today, Job tells us, in no uncertain terms, that when we believe in God, then faith will be tested. And your faith will be tested by that invitation of the Lord, alika muna sa kabilang ibayo. And you know what he was inviting them to? From a point of comfort, a situation of comfort where everybody was a believer, to go across the other side of the lake where they were all unbelievers, that's the Gerasenes, the territory of the pagans. They were taking care of pigs, and pigs are dirty animals for the Jews. It's a no-no for them to be anywhere around pigs. And the Lord told them, let us go over and cross to the other side. And then the unthinkable happened. Biglang umunos, biglang bumagyo, biglang naglaho ang katahimikan at sila'y humarap sa isang matinding pagsubok. At pagka dumating ang matinding pagsubok, hindi lang tayo nagdadasal, sinisisi natin ng Diyos. Lord, wala pa, pakils ka ba? Wala kang pakialam, you do not care that we are about to perish. You see, prayer becomes now a blame. And I will have to tell you, as a fellow believer, that if you pray God like that, you are praying. Why? You are honest. God can take it. If you say, like Saint Teresa of Avila said, no wonder you have very few friends, Lord, because you make your friends' lives miserable. Kaya kukunti ang mga nagmamahal sa'yo. And that was a prayer that was acceptable to God. God can take it. God has wide ears. God has wide hearts, a big heart, to understand where we are coming from. And the question of the Lord is an honest prayer. Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing? To be honest with you, that is my prayer time and again. Teacher, Lord, wala ka na bang pagmamahal sa Pilipinas? Tinatanggal yung mga daliri ng mga sundalo namin sa West Philippine Sea? Pinapaulan na ng water cannons? Nagiintay na tayo magpaputok ng baril? And that will start the whole conflagration of invasion. They already have invaded us economically, politically, culturally. They are here around us, courtesy of political leaders who are dancing palsy-waltzy with them and are selling everything they could sell to them. Nababayaran ang lahat, pera-pera lang lahat. Lord, do you not care about my country? I told you last week I gave up my U.S. citizenship many decades ago because I love the Philippines. And at this point, I am praying the Lord, Teacher, do you not care about us? Do you not care about me? And yet, you know, Job is a perfect example of one who, in the words of a very famous poet many years ago, underwent so many sweat and care and cumber sorrows passing number. Walang kapantay ang pinagdaanan ni Job. Lahat ng pagdurusa, lahat ng pagtitpaninikis ng Panginoon na kanyang sinampalatayanan. Nawasak ang pamilya, namatay ang mga napeste, ang mga hayop na alaga, napeste ang mga halaman. Job, who had a beautiful life, who could afford to praise God because everything went so well, woke up one fine morning to see that he was sick, his family was broken, and all his riches were gone. But Job had the heart to continue on believing. And this is the reason why our response after the first reading is, give thanks to the Lord. His love is everlasting. Now, how do we do this? Saint Paul, in the second reading, tells us, he's holding on to his faith in the risen Lord. And his faith in the risen Lord is the end-all and be-all of everything we hope for. That is the reason why we are still in church. The reason why we still go on praying the novena to sa Ina ng Laging Saklolo. Ina ng Laging Saklolo, what a beautiful title. The Redemptorist didn't have to work hard for this novena, this devotion. It's a spontaneous devotion like no other in all the world. Saklolo is a Spanish word, socorro, ina ng laging saklolo. Bakit? Because siya'y ina na laging handang tumulong, handang sumaklolo, handang tumabang, handang tumayo sa piling natin. Bakit? Because that is what God did, His Son, her Son did on the cross. But we have to face reality. God is asleep on Good Friday. God is asleep on the cushion. God is asleep while the boat of the church is being battered black and blue, and the church, the Philippine church, is being tested to the core by so much disunity. And our El Pueblo Amante de Maria, a people so much in love with Mary, is being tested by politicians who pretend to care for us but who really care for their pockets more than anything else. Humihingi ng intelligence funds ang problema, ang tatangi ng mga estudyante. Anong gagawin mo sa intelligence funds kung hindi intelihente ang mga bata? Why? Because it's good to keep people ignorant. When people are ignorant, it's very easy to manipulate them. You just give them 3,000 before election and they elect you. You just promise the moon and the stars and fix a road that is not broken. But every time there is an election coming, yung mga kalye biglang nasisira, sinisira, at gagawin muli. Who can save us from all this? The question of Job and the question of God to Job. Who closed the sea within doors? The question of God to Job. And the question of the disciples was, who then is this, whom even wind and sea obey? It is Christ the Lord. Dominus est, it is Christ the Lord. Today, I pray, like the psalmist did long ago, Iustus quidem tu es Domine, si disputem tecum, quare via impiorum prosperatur. You are indeed just, Lord. But if I contend with thee, why do evil men's ways prosper? And I stand by the side of those whom the Lord has invited. Let us cross over to the other side. Those men who were left by their wives. You know, we often talk about wives being left by their husbands. In my 40s, almost 42 years as a priest, I have met up with men who were left by their wives. And I cannot understand how some of them were able to forgive their wives after abandoning them. Who then is this whom even the wind and the sea obey? It is not about him. It is not about that man. It's about God, who can make it possible for you to forgive those who make your life miserable. When the Lord calls you to cross over to the other side, and I know, even here, even now, everywhere I've been assigned, women who have been battered black and blue by their husbands, women abandoned, children abandoned by their fathers, and they don't seem to care, they don't seem to mind. I've seen so many women, walang inatupag kundi magpaganda, yung asawa nasa Saudi, o nasa engine room, sa mga cruise ships, sa Florida, at sa Europe. At yung asawa ay puro pagpapagandang inaatupag. At pag-uwi nung lalaki, walang ipon. Nagpagal, naghirap. How can they forgive such women? And yet, I've seen very many sad and at the same time uplifting stories of people who can forgive and forget. Because this is the power of God shining out in their personhood. Today, we are called by the Lord to cross over to the other side. Crossing over to the other side, you never know what's in the offing tomorrow. You wake up and go for a medical checkup in Paranaque Doctor's Hospital ng Paranaque, and all of a sudden you've got your blood pressure shooting up the roof and your blood sugar very high up. All of a sudden you realize that you have suffered a financial loss. You lost all your savings. sapagkat ang daming scammers sa Pilipinas na binibiktima yung mga thunders na hindi marunong magtanda ng kanilang password. At napakadaling matandaan yung password kasi 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 ang password. At madaling i-hack within 30 seconds. I've known people here 10 years ago na sinamahan pa ng scammer sa Metrobank o sa ang bangko. At sa loob ng 3 minuto'y nalimas ang mga perang pinaghirapan. And we don't know why. Bad people. Good things happen or bad things happen to good people. I have the good news that I hold on to. And I would like you to look at me and not to the emergency going on. This is exactly what I mean when we don't know what the Lord has in store for us. And I am one with everyone who suffers. Why? Because it's not like I was born yesterday. Pinahirapan din ako. The church that I love made me suffer. I cannot tell that story or those stories. All I can tell you is this. And the good news today is this. We may not be able to control the storms, but God can. We may not be able to end the storm, but we can ease the pain. And that's certain. And how do we ease the pain? It is not in denying the dragon, it's riding the dragon. Sakyan mo yung dragon. It is not in avoiding the waves, no, you have to face the waves and roll with the waves. And roll with the blows and the punches. The beautiful musical Les Miserables has a beautiful song with a very beautiful line that suits us well today. Into everyone's life, some rain must fall. And if you think no rain is falling on your life, then you must be in denial. I still have to meet somebody who can tell me to my face that I have not had a trial in my life. Really? Maybe you're a cheat. Hindi ka pa naghirap sa buong buhay mo, hindi ka sinira ang pangalan mo, hindi ka pinagwikaan ng masama ng kapitbahay mo. Congratulations, you can be ready for canonization. Into everyone's life, some rain must fall. You know, lawyers and people who are in insurance talk about act of God. And what do they mean by act of God? Halimbawa, binagyo ka at napipay yung kotse mo. Hindi babayaran niya ng insurance kasi it's an act of God. And what do we mean in our common parlance, an act of God? Something we cannot control. But when God acts in you and tells you to cross over to the other side, from hatred to love, from mistrust to faith, from discouragement to encouragement, from despair to hope, that is an act of God. Welcome Him in your life. You need it for dear life. Give thanks to the Lord. His love is everlasting.